Good morning, my dear students. A very warm welcome to you all. Today, we'll see about future perfect tense. Future perfect tense describes an event which will be completed in future with a certain point of reference. So first, let us see the form of future perfect tense in statements. So the form is subject plus shall or will plus have plus past participle plus remaining part of the sentence. So past participle means the third form of verb. So let's see examples. I shall have talked to my sister. Shall have talked. Talked is vitri form. That is past participle. Second example. He will have reached home by now. So will have reached. Vitri form of reach. That is reached. Let us see the form of future perfect tense in interrogative sentences. So the form is shall or will plus subject plus have plus past participle. So shall or will come first and then subject. In statements, subject comes first and then shall or will. Remaining form is as it is. So see, let's see the example. Shall I have talked to my sister? Second example. Will he have reached home by now? Okay. Next, the form in negative sentences. In negative sentences, the form of future perfect tense is subject plus shall or will plus not plus have plus past participle. After will, we need to add not so that it becomes negative. For example, I shall not have talked to my sister. He will not have reached home by now. So these are the forms of future perfect tense. Now let's see the use of future perfect tense. The future perfect tense is used to describe an action which will be completed at some point of time in the future. So in future, at some point of time, the action will be completed. To describe such action, we use future perfect tense. For example, by the end of this week, we shall have shifted to our new house. So by the end of this week, so it is future, and by that time in future, the action will be completed. Next example, I shall have returned from school by that time. So by that time, that action will be completed in future. Next, he will have retired by year 2021. So by year 2021, the action will be completed. Next, I shall have completed my homework before he comes. So before he comes, that action will be completed. Next, before you go to see her, she will have left the place. So to describe the action which will be completed in future at certain point of time, we use future perfect tense. Now let's move towards our last tense, and that is future perfect continuous tense. Future perfect continuous tense is used to describe an action which will continue at a certain point of time in future. So let us see the form of future perfect continuous tense in statements. So the form is subject plus shall or will plus have been plus present participle plus remaining part of sentence. Present participle means ing form of verb. For example, she will have been learning music for 2 hours. Will have been learning. It indicates future perfect continuous tense. Next example, I shall have been flying kite for long. Shall have been flying. We use ing form of verb here because it is continuous. So ing form shows the continuation. Next, let us see the form in interrogative sentences. The form is shall or will plus subject plus have been plus present participle plus remaining part of the sentence. So same examples are converted into interrogative sentence. For example, will she have been learning music for 2 hours? Second example, shall I have been flying kite for long? Okay. So this is the form of interrogative sentence in future perfect continuous tense. Now let's see the form of future perfect continuous in negative sentences. So in negative, already you know that we have to add not. So the form is subject plus shall or will not have been plus present participle plus remaining part of the sentence. For example, she will not have been learning music for 2 hours. I shall not have been flying kite for long. So these are the forms of future perfect continuous tense. Now let's see the use of future perfect continuous tense. Future perfect continuous tense is used to refer to a long action before a particular time in future. So the action which continues for long before a particular time in future, to refer to that action we use future perfect continuous tense. For example, the choir will have been singing for an hour before the play starts. So will have been singing. So the choir will have been singing for an hour before the play starts. Next, future perfect continuous tense is used to refer an action that will begin at a particular time in future and will continue beyond that time. So the action will begin at a point of time in future and it will continue beyond that time. So to describe such action, we use future perfect continuous tense. For example, Sneha will have been sleeping for 2 hours by the time the maid reaches the house. So how long she will be sleeping? 2 hours by the time the maid reaches. So until the maid reaches the house, Sneha will have been sleeping. Okay. So to describe such actions, we use future perfect continuous tense. I hope you have understood the tenses. Thank you.